Hello, my name is Yogesh and today I'll be presenting a presentation on memory decoding.
So here I go. So how is data stored in memory? So data is stored in memory in the form of bits. To store bits, we use something called binary cell, which can store one bit of information. The collection of many of these bits is called word. And usually, read and write operations in the memory occurs one word at a time. Okay, so this is how a binary cell in logical form looks. And here, select tells us whether we have selected this binary cell or not. If we have selected, then only we can perform some kind of read and write operations. And here, if read and write is equal to 0, then that means we are writing on the binary cell. If it is 1, then that means we are reading from the binary cell. And obviously output will give us the result of the reading, and input will have the data which we need to save in the or write in the binary cell. So let's look here. If read and write equals 0, then this negation will give us 1 here. And if we will AND it with the input, what we will get is the data, the input only. Here we will get the negation of input. By the way, this is only true when the select is 1. Obviously, if select is 0, then we won't be able to use this binary cell, because if select is 0, then the result of both of these AND gate will be 0. That is the input, we won't get any input. If select is 0, and the AND gate on the output will give us the output 0, which means that we won't be able to use it. So like I said, if it is 0, then we can write. If it is 1, then we can read. Okay, if it is 1, then we can read, because after negation we will get a 0, and after ANDing we will get 0 and 0 here only. So SR latch will determine whether we need to do it write or read. Okay, so that's all for the binary cell. And now, as you know, a word is a collection of binary cells. Each word has a address associated with it, with which we can locate it. The address of words are mapped to the address inputs here. If there are k address inputs, they are mapped to 2 to the power of k words. Okay, so that means we can access it with the k address inputs. Okay, so after we have selected a specific word, let's take word 1. All the select lines in it will turn 1, which means we are using this word and these binary cells associated with it. The read and write here is same as the read and write in the binary cell, connected to the every binary cell in the word, and where input data here is also connected to every binary cell. So obviously as we have only selected word 1 and we have not selected others, read and write will only perform on the word we have selected. So that's how it is. So here we have an OR gate, which we will OR outputs of all the binary cell in a column. And because the output of the non-selected is always 0, we will get our appropriate result column wise after ORing. Okay. As we are using 2 plus 4 decoder here, we have 2 address inputs and 4 addresses mapped to it, which means that we have 4 words. Okay, but what if we have like 20 or 30 address inputs? if we have something like 30 address inputs, we will have 10 to the power of 9 words. Or 10 to the power, and to construct a decoder, we will have to use 2 to the power of k AND gates here, which will be very expensive for us, because as k increases, 2 to the power k will increase exponentially, increasing the cost of building exponentially. So here we have the idea of coincident encoding, which is a two-dimension selection scheme. So here what we do is, if we have k input lines, what we do is distribute it in parts of, in two equal parts, and we use one of them as a row operation, as in row, and the other one in the column. So for example, let's just take, this would have been the original 10 bit input, which would have been in the address input. So what we are doing currently is dividing it into two parts, and one of the parts will go in row wise and the other part will go in column wise. Like here, x will consist of the first part and y will be of least significant part, and the intersection of these selected parts will give us the original selected word which we would have selected otherwise. As here we have decreased the number of inputs, we have 2 to the power k by 2 AND gates here, and also 2 to the power k by 2 AND gates in the column. So total, from original 2 to the power k AND gates, we have reduced it to the twice of 2 to the power k by 2 AND gates, which means if originally there were 124 AND gates, now there will be only twice the now there will be only 64 AND gates, twice the 32. Okay, so here we have reduced the number of AND gates. But to make it more cost effective, what we are gonna do is reduce the number of IC here. So you see, to read the input, we have k by 2 IC here and k by 2 IC here. So total we have k IC. But we can further reduce it by combining both of these inputs to a single source, like here, and using original k by 2 IC. And to differentiate whether we are doing a row selection or column selection, we have used two new variables, RAS and CAS. Initially both are one, which tells us that we are using neither row or column selection. But first what we do is select RAS as 0. This means we are going to perform a row-wise selection. Only when the row-wise selection has occurred and the data has been read or written, whatever. No, data is not written. So only after the decoding has been performed, then RAS becomes original equal to 1. And after that, CAS becomes 0. Which means we are now going to perform column-wise decoding. And this second half of the bits are decoding here. And after this decoding has occurred, CAS again becomes 1. And now we have both the decoded, and we can perform the selection now. So that's how it happens. Thank you.